Doesn't actually take a link. Oh, with the cancel there. TSO Revival, does he see it? No, he doesn't. Will he go and check one more time? Oh, he spots it. Will he go for it? Getting on in there. Oh, and the wall off. Soft wall off with the probe there. Allows TSL Onori to go ahead and get his Nexus started. TSL Revival falling a little bit behind as a result of that. Now just droning up behind this as normal. TSL Onori taking one gas. Usually take two gas with a build like this. One Zealot in production. No indication that it's chrono boosted. Just going to get that Zealot out onto the map. One Ling holds the Watchtower right here. It's been a pretty long, intense tournament, guys. We've had a lot of great players coming out today. TSL Revival here. Another Queen in tow. So good about his macro. Probably macro being one of the stronger parts of the game. Going ahead, takes the third base up here very quickly. And joining up very hard behind this. Still no gas is taken for him yet. Can TSL Onori hold this off? See what he has to offer. Looking back over here. The main base, no other tech out yet. Onori just continuing to power drones, but Revival keeping right... Revival powering drones. TSL Onori actually keeping up with him in lockstep. 36 to 37 supply here. Soft wall off here with two Zealots right up against the Cybernetics Core. Third Zealot now coming out. A fourth also on the way, looking to possibly apply a little bit of pressure. Not a lot of variety in these builds as of yet. 34 to 33 Harvesters. No one getting a clear advantage or lead yet. Gas is now being taken by TSL Revival, who is going to unsupply block himself in just a second. Following that up with quite a few workers, it looks like. Six, seven, eight workers. Six workers. And a Roach Warren getting started over here. Slowly working on these rocks, wanting to go ahead and combine these bases. Ooh, Ling will spot these four Zealots and the probe moving across the middle of the map. 51 supply to 49. And two spine crawlers on the way, Roach Warren on the way, 14 Lings. Might not be enough. Let's take a look at what's up front. Multiple pylons getting set up. TSL Onori very serious about this assault. Will he have time, though, to get all of this out and ready for workers? Roach Warren not quite done yet. Needs a little bit more time to get them out. Ooh, actually gives up this pylon right up here. It will fall, it looks like. Ooh, actually has to maintain and keep those Lings as long as possible. May start to work on the rocks. Needs to keep those Ling numbers as high as possible and will now swing around. 11 Roaches in production, but will it be enough? 7 Roaches inbound. Just enough time, just barely holding right here. And in come the Lings, taking down the Stalker, and the pylons here also will go down. Ooh, another round of warp-ins coming from everywhere. Stalker's being forced back, fighting on the creep. We'll be able to get quite a few of these pylons. The first two being taken out, and now 7 more drones running up behind this. TSL Revival really needs to take care of that pylon, and TSL Onori smartly backing away. Now down about 20 supply on 3 bases now. TSL Revival looking pretty good. Going ahead, getting speed. He was forced to make some of these spine crawlers. Doesn't have quite the infrastructure he had last game. Lair now on the way as well. We'll go ahead and finish that up, but that little attack here, pretty costly for Onori. Plus 1 finished up for him for weapons on his way to get armor right now. TSL Revival now 90 supply to the 62 of Onori. And continuing to drone up behind this and get upgrades. We do have an Evo Chamber finishing up, the Macro Hatchery as well. The Lair coming down as well. And over here on Inori's side, breaking down his rocks as well, preparing to take his third base now. Taking his third base prematurely led to his defeat. last game, unable to match the economy. 65, 67 workers now to 51.